Beloved of God, this is Father Michael, along with the rest of our team, on Concert Friday, where we allow music to lead us in prayer. Let us begin, as we do all things, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today is the first Friday of the month of November. Now for me, the month of November is really the beginning of the holiday season. Now, don't get me wrong, I realize that many of you have already done your Christmas shopping, probably sent out your Christmas cards, changed the decorations on your tree, which you've had up since Labor Day, from skeletons and spiders to turkeys and pumpkins. But as a person who's always tried to keep perspective on the holidays and the seasons of the church calendar, November is a month of blessings. You see, we've all heard someone say, "I've been blessed by God." And usually it's in relationship to some kind of success or health or family or wealth or house or job or car or whatever. We've even heard athletes thank the Lord for his blessings after winning a big game. And in all seriousness, none of that's bad, and it really is all blessing. But we want to understand the deeper reality of what a blessing is. Because in seriousness, we all want to be favored by God and receive his blessings abundantly. You know, the common understanding of what it means to be blessed by God is that he gives us good things. But if we go a little deeper, as believers, as children of God, as baptized members of his church, we come to realize that this intimate relationship with the Lord means that we are blessed in every possible way. Even in the times where we encounter challenges or difficulties or strain in our life, God's blessing does not pertain only to material things. God's blessing is born out of our being created in his likeness and image and being made part of God's family. The month of November is filled with feasts and festivals of saints and sinners, of changes and challenges, of togetherness and solitude. And through it all, God is with us. He never abandons us. And those times when we feel that he is far away, he's actually closer to us than we can imagine. And we're so blinded by the difficulties that we fail to see where God is and to recognize, I'm being blessed in this moment and prepared for something better, something greater, something more. Recently, one of our faithful listeners shared with me a song that they heard and thought I might want to use it for the God Minute. You know, for Concert Friday. They told me it was a good message and a great song. And as I played the song they sent, I realized that I had heard that song numerous times by a different artist. In fact, I heard the song for the very first time in 1988, and it was sung by Rod Stewart. I know, hold on. Before you stop listening, our listener was right. It's a great song with a great message. In fact, the whole song is genuinely a blessing prayer. I thought, as did our listener, in a time where we have been mostly focused on all the turmoil in our world, this song might just be a song to turn our focus towards God's many blessings and a desire for even more blessings to be heaped upon us. So, brothers and sisters, please take a moment and give a listen to the song Forever Young, performed by the Canadian Tenors.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the sky, climb on every rung, and may you stay.
May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you.
May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. May you stay forever young.
When the winds of change shift,
may your heart always be joyful, your song always be sung, and may you stay forever young.
Forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look upon you with kindness and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, don't forget to join us tomorrow for Marian Saturday, where we will pray the third decade of the glorious mysteries. In the meantime, take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow. May you be blessed.